are gods, we are kings. We march in faith cause we believe we can change the world to what it needs. Stand against our enemies cause we can. Yeah, can't nothing ever stop us. Take one and another will rise up. We'll endure until we reach the end. End. We are gods, we are kings, demanding change cause we believe we can.
Start keeping these laws. He's going to teach his children how to keep these laws, and your children are going to teach their children how to keep these laws. Do you know whose name they're going to think of? They're going to think of Aaron.
Right.
Aaron's name is going to live forever.
Right.
Aaron's name is going to be a good name.
Right.
So the Most High God said that name is better than anything you're talking about. Read that again, Ecclesiastes 7:1. We're going to wait till you get here.
Okay, I got it.
Just a little. Read. Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 1. A good name is better than precious ointment. A good name, a lawful name, an individual that keeping the laws of God, nor either brother or sister. That name is better than precious ointment. If you ain't keeping no laws, you're going to be forgotten.
That's right.
You're going to not only lost, you're going to be forgotten. That's where death come in. You want to speak of death? Death means you don't cease no more. You don't even, you're not even alive.
Right.
Nobody is thinking of you.
Right.
You dead and gone.
Right.
But the Most High God wants us to live forever. Read that again.
A good name is better than precious ointment.
Read.
And the day of death than the day of one's birth.
So the Most High God got you concerned on your how your life is right now. Give me that in John 8. In verse, what I want, 58?
51.
51. John 8 and 51. Watch this, Aaron. I'm going to let you get it. This is what the Most High God want our minds to be on. He want our minds to be on the living. He want us to live, 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 live. John 8 and 51. Because let me tell you something. A lot of our people walking around dead-minded right now, spiritually dead. It's no need talking about death. We've been living in death all our lives.
Right.
Let's talk about how we live. After that, we're going to get Proverbs 7 and 2.
That's right.
Read.
John chapter 8 and verse 51.
Read.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying.
So the Most High God said, verily, verily, he's making a promise. He's making a promise. He has to keep this promise. The same way you made a promise to keep the covenant, he got to keep the promise as well. Read.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my sayings.
If a man keep my sayings. What is Christ's sayings? What is Christ's sayings, though, Aaron? No, his sayings. Read it again. Stay with me, all right? Watch this. Read it again.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my sayings.
So he said, verily, verily, if a man keep my sayings. Some things that he's been saying, things that he's been teaching. What was Christ teaching?
Break it out.
Damn, what was Christ teaching? What was the black Messiah teaching? What was he teaching? Give me Matthew 19. 16.
Break it out.
What was he teaching? Before we finish the script, we got to get the sayings. He said, S-A-Y-I-N-G. He said, if a man keep my sayings, the things I'm teaching, he has to keep that. Like that beard you got, you got to keep that saying. These fringes, you got to keep that. He's saying, if a man keep that, don't shave his head. Keep that stuff I taught you. Keep doing it. That's what he was teaching. All right? So he said, keep that. And I'm going to give you a scripture more specific of what he was saying to keep. All right? Read it. This is Matthew 19, 16. Matthew 19 and 16. All right? We're going to get what his sayings are. All right? Some people don't even know what Christ, you know, not talking about you, Aaron, but our people, when they go into these churches, they don't even know what Christ taught.
They need to stop going.
Yeah, they need to stop going. But hey, the Most High God dealing with who right now? Aaron. He want Aaron to come up. I don't pray like the soldier was saying. That's a blessing itself. You ready? Let's get
Matthew chapter 19 and verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good things shall I do?
So it's like a brother like me and you, Aaron, ran up to Christ. He's like, good master, trying to, you know, suck up to him, you know, good master, man, what good things shall I do? Now watch Christ. Watch how Christ do this. I want you to pay attention how Christ do this, because we're going to walk like Christ. Watch this.
What good things shall I do that I might have eternal life?
So the little brother, the black brother, he said, how should I get to the kingdom of heaven, eternal life? See, everybody mind his own life. It ain't no devil.
Right.
Well, you got to go somewhere after this. And who says that you're going to perish before you see the kingdom? Right. The kingdom coming down here too. So nobody mind his own death, Aaron. Watch this.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good?
So Christ, guess how Christ did it. Christ said, why callest thou me good? Guess what Christ being? Humble. He said, why you walk up to me and call me good? I'm a brother just like you. Watch this, read.
There is none good but one.
You see how humble he is? There is only one good. There is only one good. Let's see who that is.
That is God.
That is who?
That is God.
Read.
But if thou wilt enter into life.
But if you want to enter into where?
Into life.
No death.
Into life.
No, I got to worry about paying my taxes on that funeral.
If thou wilt enter into life.
He wants you to enter into life. That's where he wants your mind at. He won't keep your mind on life. The life is the kingdom of heaven. Christ telling the brother, if you want to enter into the kingdom of life, his sayings, what he been teaching, we finna find out what that is. He finna tell him what he got to do to enter into the kingdom. You with me? Watch this, read.
But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments.
What is it saying?
Keep the commandments.
What was Christ teaching?
Keep the commandments.
Go back to John 8 and 51.
That's right.
So now that you know what Christ says, what his teachers were, he was teaching the commandments.
That's right.
All right, so let's see what we're going to get if we keep these commandments. We just heard that we're going to get the kingdom of heaven. Let's get another scripture. Let's see, should our mind be on death or life? Read.
John chapter 8 and verse 51. Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my sayings.
So he said, if a man keep my sayings, my commandments. Christ said my sayings. That's all I've been talking about. My sayings. My saying, the things I say are the commandments. So he said, the commandments. You with me? Verily, verily, if you keep my sayings, my commandments, read.
He shall never see death.
He said what?
He shall never see death.
He shall never see what?
He shall never see death.
Read.
Then said the Jews unto him.
So the Most High, Christ is letting us know, if you keep the commandments and sayings, you'll never see death.
Right.
It's never going to even come to your mind. So you shouldn't even be worried about that. These are the things you shouldn't be worried about. Proverbs 7 and 2. After that, give me back the one in Matthew 6. Keep him first. Read. Go ahead. What's up, man? I know you got to go. But do you know that address on that flyer now, Aaron? You got that contact number? So you learn step number one before you leave. I got you. You learn step number one that you gotta what? You gotta what? You found out you Israel. You been on that. Step number two, you gotta what? Repent. What does repent mean? To do what? To say what? That you say to who you sin? To the Most High God you sin. So
I got another one.
When you pray?
Right.
That's right, Aaron. That's right. That's it. That's our ways. That's how we used to roll. Let's bless so-called black men.
Also,
go ahead. Keep the commandments. Right. When you doing it, you keep the commandments. Keep all his laws. So I'm gonna check you. Watch this. I'm gonna ask you one more question. You got all the other check box. Now I'm gonna ask you one more. What's the other commandment of the soldiers were bringing out on how you gonna get better in this walk? What should you do? What commandment? Give me Zephaniah 2:1. Before you leave, listen to this. What did the brothers and soldiers were saying you have to do? You have to come together. You have to come together. We ain't finna forget that. We ain't finna forget that. See, you got that. That's what a humble ear. It gets you to eat it all up. Now you know exactly what to do. And I'm gonna give one more scripture. I'm gonna let you leave. Now that you know what you gotta do, give me Surah 5:7, because Aaron been listening. He don't need going back over. He got it. He been eating it up. But watch this. Don't play with God, man. All right, don't play with God. Watch this.
Surah chapter 5 and verse 1. Verse 7. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord.
Make no tarrying. I heard you when I was by this camera right here. You said, it ain't really no Israelites in Mobile. Now that you have found your family, What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Step in.
You gotta step in. You ain't got no choice, cause I'm finna read you a scripture that you ain't got no choice but to step in. Or the Most High God gonna step you out. We gonna read it. Watch this.
Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord.
Make no tarrying. Don't take your time. Alright?
And put not off from day to day.
Don't wait till the seventh day and say, man, I got the address and the phone number right here. But man, I just ain't finna go today, man. I got too much going on, man. I ain't finna go today. I know what I'm supposed to do. I understood everything they were saying out there that day, Sunday. But now it's the Sabbath. I know I'm supposed to be congregating, but I ain't finna do it. Watch what God say gonna happen to you if you play with him. Watch this, read.
For suddenly.
For what?
Suddenly.
What does suddenly mean? You ain't got no time to think.
Right.
It's done. Your time up. Suddenly, what?
For suddenly shall the wrath of the Lord come forth.
For the whose wrath?
Shall the wrath of the Lord come forth.
Read.
And in thy security.
In thy where?
Thy security.
When you at home chilling, when you at the truck chilling, when you at the job chilling, when you at grandma's house chilling, when you at pop's house chilling, when you chilling in your security, when you think you secure, what's gonna happen?
Thou shalt be destroyed.
You gonna be destroyed.
Bishop Nathanyel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.